say happy birthday to all the Marines out there. Happy belated birthday. It's the Marine Corps' 238th birthday yesterday. So good on you for 238 years of glorious service to the country. Graduation, I decided to join the United States Marine Corps. I wanted to be an infantryman. I went to boot camp and graduated from Marine Corps Recruit Depot, San Diego, California, on September 12th, 2008. This date would mark one day after the seventh anniversary of the tragedy that happened on September 11th, 2001. Trained for just under a year, and I deployed to Afghanistan from late October 28, 2009 to May of 2010. I served with Golf Company 2nd Battalion, 2nd Marine Regiment, 2nd Marine Division, which is based out of Hampton, Virginia, North Carolina. I spent 7 months patrolling, leaving off meals ready to eat, serving MREs, trying to win the hearts and minds of the locals. And the biggest job was trying to fight the insurgency that had plagued Afghanistan for so many years. My base had no running water, no internet, and one satellite phone for 55 Marines and sailors. I got to call home, and this all depended. I got to call home once every 9 to 15 days. Sometimes it was later than that. I can tell you that one of the hardest things about calling home is to decide which parent you're going to call. Is it going to be mom or dad? I would call home. If one didn't pick up, I would try the other. And one time I had the unfortunate experience of neither parent picking up. So I called my grandma Rose. When she picked up, I said, "Hey, Grandma, it's Aaron." She goes, "Aaron who?" "Your grandson, Aaron." And she definitely was not expecting a phone call from Afghanistan early in the morning. So I think I startled her there for a little bit. I can never truly explain what it's like to deploy to the Middle East, to have friends die in front of you, or the fear of being in a firefight. However, I can express my thanks and gratitude to everyone that has supported me, not only me, but everybody that has deployed or is deploying over the last 12 years of the war in Iraq and Afghanistan. Male is by far the greatest motivator when deployed. And what I mean by this is it will and can morally and mentally break you or make you. I remember it was a month before we got a mail drop. Our first mail drop came. Well, it didn't get all the way to us. It was a convoy coming down Mount Cowboys. It was like 6 or 7 trucks long, and the Taliban had laced the road with a daisy chain improvised explosive device. It blew 3 of our vehicles completely to shreds. Thankfully, everybody in the convoy survived. But then we got the news that our water truck, our food truck, and God forbid, our mail truck was hit. And I don't think any of you would know what it's like or how ticked off a bunch of Marines were waiting on mail for a month and was almost there, and then blew up. So, for those of you that did send me and have sent Nick, Mr. Glover, Today marks the 95th anniversary of Veterans Day, or as it was once called, Armistice Day. As many people know, Armistice Day was the day that ended put World War I into a ceasefire. The ceasefire was signed on the 11th hour, the 11th day, the 11th month. Armistice Day changed Veterans Day after World War II to recognize all veterans that have served in all of our country's conflicts and future conflicts. South Dakota has roughly 73,000 living veterans, which is approximately 11% of our state's population that is 18 years or older. That being said, there are roughly 73,000 men and women in South Dakota that should and deserve to be recognized, along with the nearly 1 million veterans that live in the United States. I'm a third-generation veteran. I'm a third-generation infantryman and a second-generation Marine. I grew up on values such as respect, teamwork, and citizenship. Respect is something that I learned at a very young age, but I did have a few hiccups here and there, as does everyone. In elementary school, I remember our class would take the 60 seconds it took to recite the Pledge of Allegiance. Something that was as simple and as powerful as the Pledge of Allegiance was one of the first things I ever memorized and gained the respect. Then, in the older elementary grades, I believe it was in fourth or fifth grade, they said that we couldn't recite it anymore because people didn't agree with one phrase that was in it: "One nation under God." I ask myself nowadays, what happened to those morals and standards that I grew up with as a young child? A generation is sometimes looked at as having no morals or standards, that anything goes, all for me, none for you. Sometimes I feel a little embarrassed at myself and at my generation. At times I feel as though myself and my generation need a swift kick in the butt and a reality check. Teamwork. Everyone needs to learn how to be a team player at some point in their life. Without teamwork, this nation would have failed at its very beginnings in 1776. Teamwork and pride have always contributed to the greatness of our country and the jealousy of all foreign nations since our founding. Acceptance and teamwork are what will make you successful in life and at times express your true character. I'm going to go on and say, for those of you that are thinking about joining the military, I have the utmost respect for you. You are joining in a time of a lot of conflicts. But I will challenge you to really think about why you want to join. Join for the right reasons, and not just because your parents or grandparents want you to. Want to join for yourself, and make sure you serve with dignity, honor, and compassion at all times. I only have one story left that I'd like to tell everybody. It started in a boot camp where I learned a new perspective on life. I was being taught the Marine Corps motto, which is a Latin phrase, Semper Fidelis, which means always faithful. And it was taught to me like this: be faithful to God, to the poor, and to your country. Be faithful to your fellow man and woman. Be faithful to those who came before you and those who fight for you or beside you. We all have responsibilities as citizens of the United States. Let's not forget those who have fought for us and are still fighting for our freedom and who have sacrificed so much so that we may live in the land of the free. Thank you, and Senator Fidelis.